What's up, guys? Today we have a blue-red spells, blue-red turns, blue-red dragons, whatever you want to call it. Goldspin Dragon, one of the best cards in Standard, obviously. Plus Smoldering Egg, one of the most exciting cards from the new set. It is very similar to Thing in the Ice. Like, if you remember these decks, these blue-red decks from, you know, Modern, for example, even though you're not really playing, you know, through your graveyard, it does work similarly that you play this egg on turn two, then you do a bunch of stuff in the next couple of turns, you know, you kill some of their creatures, maybe you counter something, and then you flip this into a pretty big dragon that whenever you cast an instant or a sorcery, it deals 2 damage to any target. So it's pretty trivial to finish the game, you know, once you flip that. It works really, really nicely with Epiphany, because that's exactly the 7 mana you need to flip it. So, you know, you time walk, make a 4/4 out of the egg. Next turn, you attack for 6. If you have another time walk, then they're pretty much just, you know, already dead. Memory Deluge is another new card that should work pretty well in this deck. And I already played a bunch of games. Too bad I didn't record it, because I had some really, really sweet games. I played a bunch of mirrors, played against some creature decks. And obviously, this is the kind of deck that you're going to need to tune for the right metagame. Like, if the metagame is a bunch of control decks, then maybe, you know, you don't really want to play Cinderclasm main. But if there's a lot of creatures, then Cinderclasm is one of the best cards, because it can clear the opponent's side of the board. Maybe you want to play Burn Down the House in the main if there is, you know, a lot of Ren and 7 decks, or if it just feels like that's the card you would like to have against the decks people play. Heat the Debate in the sideboard is one of the best cards for the mirror. I played a couple of mirrors, and in the first mirror, I didn't have that, my opponent did, and I had a bunch of counter spells in my hand post board, and my opponent just always had the debate for my Goldspin Dragon or Smoldering Egg, and I was just like, yeah, I would really wish I could counter this, but, you know, that's not going to be an option. The sideboard is just a bunch of counter spells, something against creatures, you know, Burning Hands, obviously, for the green decks, the Vren and 6 decks, the Essica's Chariot decks, the 4th Cinderclasm, Burn Down the House, pretty standard stuff, really. Some counter spells in the main, extra Civic Iteration, like, you're not really going to find an Izzet deck these days without 4 iterations. So yeah, let's play some games. Traditional, Standard, let's go. You can build the mana base a little bit differently. You don't have to play so many of the double face cards. Instead, you can play the blue-red snowlands, the tapped ones, the duels that you can also show to the snarlands. And you can also, there's a lot of cards you can play. You can play 4 consider and, you know, cut a land or two. You can play the 3-mana bounce a permanent, make a treasure. That also seems like a pretty reasonable card. There's just so many ways to build this deck. Awkward hand. I guess I'm gonna have to go Snarl, Pathway, and then tapped Snarl if I don't get a land. World Championship Sleeves, look at that. I wonder if I have any sound effects on. Alright. I guess I could also do this. What did they do? Okay. Okay, now it's easy. Show an island. Suspend or foretell. I'm just gonna keep calling this suspend. Green white. Okay, that's probably the Ram deck. So now we can just kind of sit on counters, not really have to do much. Hopefully they're gonna have Essica's Chariot, which we're gonna force spike. Or just any other 4-drop would be really nice. Or maybe, you know, catch a Vren 7 with that next turn. Puts lands into play. I don't know if I want to counter that. It's going to make my 4-spike worse, but I don't think I'm going to be countering the 2-3. I I guess I could have countered it because I'm going to start taking a lot of damage from their creatures. And I have a lot of counters, so maybe I should have done that. It also makes my force spike worse. Yeah, I think that was maybe a little too greedy to not do that. Hopefully they're going to use this, put a light into play, you know. Oh my god, if they have a land, I'm gonna get so screwed. Yep, they have a land. I have to use the solid coming too. No, okay, never mind. Now they're probably sitting there thinking, yeah, maybe I should have cast it first before attacking. Epiphany, okay, that's kind of nice. I think I'm going to play Iteration. I think I'm very likely going to be forced to use a counterspell on something they play. So this is going to help me build up my mana base. Okay, nice. So in my hand goes a Dragonfire. And I'm going to play an island. And pass. These are exactly the types of decks you want to play against. Just something that isn't, you know, too fast, not super aggressive. They give you time to, you know, use your card advantage spells, you know, your iterations, your memory deluge. You just sit on the counter spells and... I think I'm gonna counter that. I wanna use the Dragon's Fire on the 2-3, and I really don't wanna get greedy and, you know, let them resolve a bunch of spells when I have two counters ready, and like Memory Deluge is gonna give me more cards, and just no reason to get greedy. If I had a Cinderclasm, obviously that'd be different, but. Oh, okay. Well, then I guess I'm gonna have to kill the Good Swarm now. Goldspin Dragon is nice. So let's play this on red. Definitely play the Goldspin. I guess I'll just let them have the Scoot Swarm. Cause I can't afford to have them resolve of red and seven. And like, sure, this is nice. If they get to play a land, it's gonna be the sixth one, so they get to make a copy of this. But it's not the biggest deal. I have Epiphany, and if they play red and seven, I would be really screwed. So I'm just gonna be able to find a Cinderclasm with this probably. The Florahedron is not attacking. That's interesting. Yeah, another card they can play is Emeria Skull. This is fine, I'm taking four. No big deal. Shar, I mean, I can chum block that. Doesn't matter. I could use the Dragon's Fire on the 1-1 now. Still want to keep this for Ren and 7, I think. With the 1-1s, I'll be able to chump block for a while. So the 4-4 is not really that scary. Wait, what the hell? Why can we play this? Okay, what's going on? Oh, Yasharn! I can't use my treasure! Oh my god, I didn't realize that. I did not realize that. Yeah, well, in that case, I guess we're gonna foretell. Wow, that's a thing. Like, you keep thinking of this as like a historic card, right? Of the company decks and like stopping the sacrifice decks from doing their thing. But yeah, I guess it works against treasures in standard too. I'll kill the 2/3 thing. Actually, I can kill Yasharn, that's better. Because I have the Goldspit Dragon. Yeah, I can kill Yasharn, that's better. And that even makes my treasure do something. So if they don't do anything, I can play the Memory Deluge. That's cool, I think. That's cool, right? If they get a bunch of creatures, I play Deluge. And if I find either another Epiphany or the egg would work too, I think. I can also just counter it. Maybe that's just better. Not play the Deluge, play the Deluge next turn. Attack them down to 8, play Epiphany, attack them down to 2. But then I'm not gonna have mana for Deluge and another Epiphany. Actually, I am, because I'm making treasures when I'm attacking, so that works. Yeah, I'll counter it then. Oh, okay, so I can do egg. Egg first, Epiphany second, next turn Deluge, and if I find any spell, then I can shock them to death. Easy game. Yeah, that's exactly kind of how you want the game to go. We had land drops to make, you know, every turn. We had pretty much everything this game. Like everything just lined up perfectly. Like they played like a relatively slow deck. They're really taking their time here. Okay, Goldspin Dragon works too. Let's go. So green white, lots of creatures. Cinderclasm definitely coming in, although it kills Swarm, it kills the 1/1. It doesn't kill this, it kills the creatures from Chariot. I think it's okay. I think we want that. I think we want Burning Hands as well. And burn down the house. The question is, what do I not want? Maybe Dragon's Fire? Because Burning Hands is just better. Like if I have Dragon's Fire and they have Chariot or Yasharn and I don't have Goldspin Dragon, then I don't actually deal enough damage to kill it. So I think I'm gonna cut these because we don't want to have that many burn spells. Stroke is okay. I could have more strokes too. I could cut like one Deluge, like two Epiphany is not the most necessary thing ever. Wonder if I have too many burn spells now. Maybe 3 is enough. Is it though? Because I also have the burn down the house. Maybe I just don't need Epiphany. But every time I cut that card from my deck when I used to play Blue Red Dragons, I always regretted it, so I don't really want to do that. But it kind of feels like, yeah, maybe it's not necessary. Really not sure what to do. Yeah, but I don't really need it. Like, I'm going to have the egg, I'm going to have the Goldspin Dragons, and I have Memoria Dilute. Yeah, I think this is just not necessary. But I kind of want to have the fourth Deluge now, because I'm just going to play a game where we trade resources, and I guess three is enough. Yeah, we're gonna keep that. We don't have a lot of lands, but I have enough answers. Innkeeper, okay, that's perfect for this Interclasm. I think I need to play. No, I'll play the egg. This is tough. Because I need to have a counter up for Vrenin 7. I think I have to foretell this. Because next turn I need to have this. Oh boy, that's bad. That sucks. Yeah, actually, I should have played the egg. I have burning hands for the Vrenin 7, even if they have that on turn four. And I can just start putting counters on this, which is probably more important. Just need to draw a land. Come on. I guess we're playing this. Well, that sounds a lot like Ren. Yep, that's unfortunate. Everything just went wrong this game. Like, not having the lands is so brutal. If I had the lands, like last turn, I would have just Cinderclasmed their board away at the end of their turn. Like, I would have taken the damage from Chariot, then at the end of their turn, I would just Cinderclasm, just kill their entire board. They only have a Chariot, they can't crew. And next, I can hold up the counter spell, so. Be relatively easy. Yeah, that's not gonna really help me, is it? What now? What now? I wonder if I should kill the Vren. They're gonna get so many lands. Kinda screwed either way. I think I need to kill the token and just eventually deal with the Vren with the burn down the house. Although, yeah, I don't really know. I'm just in a spot where I don't think I can really do all that much. Okay, they're not two lands. Got two lands up here. Fight anymore. Nope. Skyclave. That's an interesting one. Well, that's another card that dies with Cinderclasm. Yeah, I have to let that happen. Okay, there's 28 lands in the deck, including all the all the double face cards, so not having lands or expressive iteration is really unfortunate, but sometimes it just happens, I guess. Yes, 23 regular lands, and then you have 5 of the double face cards. It's 28 and 4 iteration help you find lands as well, so that was really unfortunate. I think I'm leaving it like this. Just gonna beat them with Goldspin Dragon, I think. Don't really need the Epiphanies. That's a weird hand. I mean, I guess I'm keeping her. The question is, do I play one of these as a land? If I draw more lands, then I would just rather use all of them. They do have spells on curve. I think I'm gonna play one. Yeah, I'm gonna play one. If I was on the draw, I would just decide based on what I draw in the first turn, but I think I'm gonna play this first one as a land. Just wanna have Goldspin on turn five. I guess I could also just play Snarl into a mountain and then use one of the disruptions, and then on turn 3, if I don't draw a land, I can just play a tapped land. Because I don't really have anything that costs 3 mana anyway, so having my third land come into play tapped wouldn't really matter. Well, that's getting 4 spiked. Okay, we're gonna play the hazard. And next I play Goldspin. Okay, that's perfect. So now we probably play Yasharn or Chariot, which I force spike. Next I play Goldspin, get the treasure, pass after attacking, obviously. They have 5 mana next turn. They probably play Vren, for which I have Disdainful Stroke. Attack back for 8, so they're at 8. Yeah, this should be fine. I really like the disruptions in this deck. They're really nice. I just need one more interactive card and I'm good. One Burning Hands, one Counterspell. Everything is actually going the way we expected. That also works, because even if they play Vren, I can just attack for 8 next turn. Nice. Okay. No, just get the creature back, right? Okay. Nice. Yeah, basically, whatever you do with this deck, you just need to make sure that Vrenin 7 doesn't resolve, because that card is really, really dumb. The fact that it makes it threefold with Reach is really, really nice against the Goldspin Dragon decks. Sorry to all the Japanese viewers for blowing my nose. Okay, let's play one more. Oof, awkward hand. I think we keep though. On the play, I think I keep. If I was on the draw, I think that would be a mulligan, but I think on the play, it's a keep. I'm just going to put this into play tap. No reason to show them other stuff. Oh, okay, that's another green-white deck, I guess. So now we just want to draw like a Goldspin Dragon or the egg would be really nice. So they're probably going to play a Sharn. I wonder if I... No, this is funny. Why are people playing this card? Like, this card doesn't seem very good to me. I understand, like, it makes you extra mana, but, like, it makes a Lotus Petal. Like, is it really worth a card to get a 1-1 that gives you a Lotus Petal? Like, the 1-1 is basically, like, irrelevant. I'm gonna be dead before I can do anything. But yeah, this is the biggest mystery to me that like so many decks are playing this now. Like I get this card in like, you know, historic collected company deck. Makes a lot of sense. You have collected company to play on turn three, so getting the treasure is really important. And it's also a card you can hit in company, so you can put it into play later. The treasure also works, you know, it's a synergy with your sacrifice stuff. So it, all that stuff makes sense. But just run this as a card in standard just to like get some life. I don't know if that's really that important. Egg, okay. So I'm kind of dead if they have another Vren. Like they clearly have another 5-drop because they play the tapped land. But if it's just like Essica's Chariot or something, then I should be okay. I don't think they have any bump spells really. They can play the charm thing. But I don't think this deck plays that. We'll see, I guess. And so if I was at 20 life, I probably, you know, would have strongly considered not blocking, but here I think it's an easy block. We need some spells. Memory Deluge would be really, really nice here. Dragon's Fire is also cool. Because it's gonna deal 4 once I flip it. So yeah, let's do this. Doesn't have reach, right? No vigilance. Oh, wow. That's perfect. That's literally like probably the best card. It's probably even better than Deluge because it lets me use my mana better. I think I need to kill their creatures. Oh wow. Okay. So this can actually take down a creature. So I can do both, right? I don't need the land. So in my hand goes iteration. And this goes in the library, this gets exiled. So now I can use the Spikefield Hazard to deal with this. I guess I'll play iteration first, because I still can find a land with this. Oh, they're not even gonna be able to crew the chariot. Wow, this thing is really busted. Oh well, okay, we're good. And we're not gonna be able to play a land off of it. We're just gonna get one card, but that's fine. I mean, I'm gonna get Epiphany and I think that should be game. I could get Deluge actually, just in case they have Renin 7. What if that happens? So I'm gonna use Hazard. Oh yeah, I can't really play the Deluge, so I'm gonna get the Epiphany here. You can only foretell from your hand, I think. This goes in the library, and I guess we exile the gold spend. Try getting the left one. Okay. So I can actually, so the way I can do it is I can leave this back and chump block the chariot, and if they play Vren after that, then I can just save this for the token, because it's going to be a 6-6, and this combined with the dragon deals 6 damage. Let's just stack with everything. I think I can race friend. Yeah, this thing is really nice. Thing in the Ice is very similar. Like, it's a decent blocker early, and then you just kind of win the game with it. That deals with the dragon. That's unfortunate. Oh, and I can't kill the chariot. So I have to just play the dragon's fire now to kill their creatures, I think. And I deal 4, and then, yeah, I'm going to be fine, I think. God, so it's a device. So I'll deal with their board. Everything dies. Even if they have another creature, like another root grazer, then that's fine. They can crew chariot and attack for a little bit. Oh, looks like they have a scoot swarm, so they're gonna attack for 4, make another swarm, which is fine. I just attack for 4, play Epiphany, attack for 6, and they should die. Oh, another chariot, okay, that's also fine. Yeah, that was a really nice game. Play this first and they might just scoop right away. I'm gonna make the math, do the math. I wonder if you should just have the 4th Disdainful Stroke in the sideboard. Like, everybody is running Chariot and Ren and, you know, all these mid-rangey expensive cards. In the mirror, it's also fine because it counters Deluge, it counters Goldsmith Dragon, it counters Epiphany. Okay, so same thing. We just want to have a lot of answers. I don't know if Burnt Down the House is actually good for this matchup, but it should be. Like, it's kind of weird if you play it when you have creatures in play, because that obviously means you're killing your own board. But I want to keep trying it. Like, maybe it's not good enough, and I'll change my mind eventually. Like, maybe this is just better, because it kills Chariot, it kills your Sharn. It costs less mana, but I think just having a sweeper is okay on the draw. Burn down. Okay, we can try it. We can try it in this situation. That's kind of the perfect setup for it too. Like, we have some lands, a counter spell for like a Chariot or Vren, and then we have burn down the house to just clear their board. When you play this deck, sometimes it's better to. Like, let's say I have an island and I have a pathway in my hand. Sometimes it's better to play the pathway because you can end up drawing Snarl next turn and you want to put it into play on tap. So leaving, and like, obviously in a normal situation, you would always play island first and then leave pathway in your hand because that gives you more choices later. But sometimes it's in this deck specifically, it's better to do it the other way around sometimes. Maybe I have to. Actually, I think I'm passing here. Because I can use Burning Hands on something like a Yasharn, and then turn 3 use this. If I foretell this, then next turn I can only use one of these two cards. The worst for me here would be Chariot. Yeah, Yasharn is fine. If I foretell this, then next turn I'm in a spot where I'm taking already 5 damage from their board, and I have to hold up a counter spell for their Renan 7 or for something that they are very likely going to play. So it's better to just leave up the mana, play Burning Hands, next turn play my third land, hold up Soi Coming. Now, all I care about is like Ren and Chariot, really. I don't really care about anything else. I don't even know if I want to counter this, because I can just burn down the house everything in 2 turns. But I play my 4th land, they play their 5th, then I play my 5th, so it's a 5-5. But maybe they could just find a way to put a land into play or something, so maybe it's just better. It's safer to just counter it. I can also play Deluge with an empty board. This was the reason why I wanted to board one out. Because I didn't want to get stuck with 3, with a bunch of them in my hand. Oh wow, that's brutal. They find actually it's not that bad, because they still only have 5 lands. Oh my god, no way! Oh my god, I did not realize that. I wanted to wait, see what they get, and then play Deluge. You know, to know exactly what I'm looking for. I did not realize that they could get Raydane. Oh my god, that's bad. Now I can't do anything. I literally cannot do anything. Wow, that's brutal. Wow. What the hell? That sucks. I could have found like a Goldspun Dragon with it, you know, start getting some. Man, now I'm just literally dead. Maybe find a burning hands to deal with the chariot. This card is really nice, by the way. It's a really cool card. I like it. The fact that it can find you Vren is really nice. Yeah, I'm dead. I mean, I can give it one more turn, but... Yep. It might be dead. I'm actually dead, yeah. I should have countered that. I'm gonna admit I didn't really do the math. 3, 10, 11, wait, no. 12, yeah, it's 13. Okay. But even if I do that, like, I was gonna find a land, try to play burn down the house, hope they don't have another creature to create the chariot, but I'm extremely likely just super dead. Yeah, I don't really know about this. The fact that they have raiding, like, should I just have, maybe on the play I don't need that, maybe I just have these two, because it also kills raiding. Kills Chariot, kills Yasharn. Weird hand. I think we have to keep. The problem is we kind of have to play this on turn 3 to find lands, but at the same time I want to have mana up for this. If they play Florahedron here, I'm definitely playing Cinderplasm just to get rid of it. Because that means I can play Iteration without the fear of them playing a 4-drop here. It sucks. Yikes, I can't play the Iteration now. Yeah, you're gonna need to find like a good balance between the, you know, answers, counters, removal spells, card draw spells. It can definitely get a little weird when you draw like too many of one of those cards. Like basically last game we had 3 Deluge, which we didn't really have time for. Raiding. Sure. Now I have Cinderplasm and it doesn't do anything. It is a little weird. So I guess I can do this, try to find a land. Hold up stroke. That's fine. So I can double Cinderplasm. Okay, we can do that. Clear their board. So put Cinderplasm in my hand. Force Spike in the library. Exile the island, play the island. Pass the turn, and I need 4 red sources next turn. So I have to play this on red, and then I can just play Cinderplasm and deal with their board. Okay, that works. Maybe I need to keep the Dragons fires, but they can get so awkward. Like when you don't have the dragons, they have like a chariot. It just feels so bad. This is getting countered. Oh, nice. So what I'm gonna do is now I play iteration, try to find out of the land, have a stroke for the 6 mana card or for another Vren. The next turn I can Cinderclasm with the board away while holding up the stroke if they don't play anything. Thinking forward, not a big deal. Play Deluge, I think it's iteration here. Just need to remember to play the pathway on red. So debate in my hand, island. And debate in my hand. Library, island gets exiled, play the island. I was kind of hoping to find another counter spell, but we should be fine anyway, unless they have two more big spells. If they have two more big spells, then I can definitely get screwed. But their deck is a lot of lands. Like they have a lot of mana sources. They have a lot of cards like Flora Hedron, cards like the 3 mana Find a Land. So hopefully they're gonna run out of cards at some point. Oh wow, this is kind of brutal. Okay, so I'm gonna I don't think I do anything. I'm just gonna pass. And I try to kill everything next turn. Red, red. So my plan is I hope they crew chariot. Okay. Make a lair, a 4/4. Or the other one, because it's a 3/4, and then I just clear their board. Oh wait, this costs 3. I'm not actually gonna be able to keep the stroke up. Well, that's just what it is. Oh my god, we're doing it. We are doing it. Okay. Red, blue, red. Wow, that's so brutal. Holy crap. You love to see it. And now we have a stroke for anything. If they had one more land, they attacked me with the 5/5 lair, would have been kind of screwed. But that didn't happen. Okay, now it's gonna be a walk in the park, really. Like this is gonna give me more counter spells. I have the heated debate for 3/4. Ideally, they activate it. What about Yasharn? I care about Yasharn? Not really. I guess I can start with Deluge. Good egg. And a pathway. How bad is it if they get more lands? If they have the 6 drop, then they can flesh it back right away. Maybe I do counter it. No, I don't want to get greedy here. I have mana to flashback the deluge. No, right? 3 for 5. Oh, one of the cards in their hand can very likely be a Skyclave, actually. I shouldn't have maybe played this. Yeah, I should have just used the Deluge, maybe. I guess I could just counter the Skyclave and Deluge next turn. Yeah, that was what I thought maybe they could have. Okay, line number 7. So I can play this on my own turn to flip it, or I can deal 4 to them, but that seems bad. So I'm going to use the Deluge, keep up a dual land, flip the egg. Okay, get a stroke. And a solid coming, I guess. Is that even better than extra civic iteration? Maybe iteration is just better. 3 more cards. Yeah, I think iteration is just better than a counter here. Because I can very likely just kill them next turn. I counter whatever they do, and then next turn, this is 2 damage, this is 6. With the attack, it's 12. So I just, yeah, I can just burn my own guy, and that should be a awkward zone. It's a bad. Nope. I really like this card, by the way, the Storm. Storm the Festival. It's a cool card. Oh wait, start with this. Well, it doesn't really matter, but oh, creature or planeswalker. Oops. Why did I think this could target players? I mean, I could just target my own creature and force spike it. Doesn't really matter, but why did I think this could target players? I guess this would be a nice card for like a mono red burn deck or something. Wow, the four spikes are so brutal against this deck. Holy crap. You get value out of them even on turn like 11 or something. That's crazy. All right, let's play one more match. Hopefully we get like a blue deck mirror now. Like we played against the green decks. Now it would be cool to show off a blue mirror. That was a really cool match. The last game was really, really crazy. Goldspin, no red mana. I'm on the draw the mulligan. I think I'm gonna keep. Might be a little ambitious, but I should be able to get, I mean, I'm playing 28 lands, come on. Oh, we are playing the mirror. Oh, okay, never mind, we're not playing the mirror. Wait, what the hell? I have no clue what they're playing. Absolutely no clue. So I can do this foretell. Next turn, if I don't draw a land, I play this as a land. I can use Solid Coming. And then Deluge is going to find me red sources, hopefully. This is kind of nice, I guess. We're going to counter that. Disruption Iteration. That's an interesting deck they're playing. Excuse me. Well, we still don't have a red source. That is awkward. I wonder if I should play this now. I actually should. I should have played the Deluge right away. Because now they can just like get a Force Spike with this or whatever. They couldn't get a spell in their graveyard. That's weird. I mean, I'm pretty dead. I don't have the red sources. Like, if I could play Goldspin now, that'd be a different story, but without it, I am pretty dead. I definitely need a Mountain. And then I think I need Epiphany, and I just hope that I draw. Well, I don't know if I have a way to win. Four or more instants or sorcery, they have three. I'm just going to take this and hope that's going to work out. So I'm going to use Dragon's Fire in the 1-3, I think, because otherwise it's going to be too big. The problem is... Actually, no, that should be fine. What the hell? It's a funny. Somebody is bored. Okay, well, we still have a chance. No red source. I can play the Time Walk, but that's about it. Okay. Now we're cooking. So I attack with the Goldspin, then cast Deluge, and hopefully I find another... Oof, okay, that sucks. I need to find another Time Walk. Oh, I need to play this now also, because when this is gone, it doesn't give you two mana, so I need to play Deluge right now. I need to play Deluge? Yeah, I need to play Deluge, because then I'm not using my mana at all this turn. No Time Walk. So I guess I'm just hoping I draw Time Walk next turn. So if I play Goldspin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I have 2, 3 mana left, 2 treasures. Okay. So I take Goldspin Dragon and Egg. And my only hope is I draw a Time Walk next turn. Oh wait, no, I don't, that doesn't work actually. It does work with the Egg though. No, it doesn't. Still 1 mana short. Cinderclasm, well, that doesn't do anything. I can play Goldspin Dragon to block, but I'm still taking 5. So I can play... Can't really do much. Goldspin... Attack, get 2 red sources. That also doesn't work. Alright. Yeah, in hindsight, maybe mulliganing would have been better. So, Cinderclasm does nothing. Stroke does nothing. Test of Talents could be nice. Heated Debate is definitely great for their creatures. This is maybe interesting. I kind of think I want Negate for their like iterations, like the bounce spells or whatever, the ways they're gonna have to kill my creatures. What's my worst card? I could board on like one Deluge, one Epiphany. They have four spikes, they're definitely gonna have negates or something. So Epiphany boarding out is definitely reasonable. Maybe I just got both. Two Epiphanies, I mean, and just have two negates. This is fine. I would like to play first. It feels like this deck could use like one more threat. Because it's a world of difference when you have a turn two egg or when you already have a Goldspin Dragon. Ooh, Delver of Secrets, okay. I guess I could have figured that out, that they have that in their deck. Yeah, maybe Burn Down the House would be okay. How do we play this? Mountain Go. Sure, I think I'm going to be using this as a four spike this game. Oh, nice. Okay, so I can do that to kill this. And this. Don't need to really do anything. Well, wouldn't you know it? So they can bounce their own guy. What you got? Memory Deluge, Fading Hope, Stroke. Yeah, this was the reason why I wanted to board out the Time Walk, because they just have so much stuff. I guess I can take a look at their deck. Iteration, Delver, Consider. I mean, now I pretty much just seen everything. I'm a little surprised they didn't bounce their own guy. I guess they can still do it. Okay. This would be a really nice turn to have a land so that I could play Goldspin Dragon. What the hell? What am I doing? I could play Memory Deluge. Instead of Iteration. Like, they very likely play, like, if they, I didn't see if they scry top or bottom. If they scry top, they probably have a land. They're going to play the 2-drop and then hold up mana for the Stroke. I just want to use 4 mana, really. Actually, sure, let's play the Deluge. Oh, wow. Yeah, then I just use, I get both. Because this kills Delver now. I'm gonna need to check if my cat is okay. Supaya! Supaya! Kotsura! Supaya! Supaya! Oh my God, Nolan, are you kidding me? Well, that is brutal. That is just absolutely brutal. What? My God, I don't know what to do. Think I got a gold spin dragon? No, I get the deluge. Wow, that sucks. Not finding a line in that is really rough. It's need to counter this. Hydro land, I can play gold spin plus negate. Okay. Do I want to do that though? I think so. Gold spin negate. Then they use the four man the four damage thing. So but they don't draw a land, they can play the deluge. I think it's fine. I guess I can use Deluge first to find a land, but I'm gonna get so much mana advantage that I should be fine here. I could have played it slower. I could have just played Deluge for four, you know, get Solid coming in the Foretell zone or something. Hold up my spells. So they already have, they drew a land, I suppose. Because they could have just played the four mana spell first to try to hit a land and something. No, they didn't. And they, wow, okay, then that's a really bad order. That is a really bad order. Oh, I should have played this the deluge before the goldsmith died. That was bad. Because now it only gives me two mana. Yeah, I definitely should have done that. That was really bad. That was incredibly bad.
Kocoure, co děláš?
Have their own deluge, which I can counter. If they have a force spike, I'm super screwed. Which one is the one that they're playing? This one. Mean, I hope that's the one. Please don't force spike me here. This. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. I have eight mana. So if I get double egg, I can go egg, deluge. They can flashback their own deluge. If I go egg iteration, think I get two eggs. Might be wrong, but seems reasonable to me. I need to start like trying to finish the game quickly. Well, now I wish it had the other card. Also, don't tap my red sources, please. I know they didn't have anything to deal with the with my spells, so I'm just gonna cast it now to make sure it resolves. Ooh, those are nice. Those are really nice. I could maybe even win next turn. Oh no, that sucks. casting that instead of the, I guess that makes sense. Well, I can also just die to this, but I have a bunch of burn in my deck. Dragon's Fire, the Heated Debate. They can attack with the land. So I block the land, take one, go to four, three. Yeah, I'm gonna need to find like a Time Walk or something, because I'm just kind of dead next turn. I was hoping that with Double Egg and Goldspin Dragon, I was gonna be able to just kill them next turn, but I don't think that's gonna work now. Ooh, nice, okay, that's great. So how do we do this? I have 8 mana, so if I play Goldspin Dragon attack, I have 5 mana left. Then I can play Debate. Debate on the Channeler. Shoot this iteration, shoot the other one, and just kill their board. That sounds pretty good to me. Wait, but then I don't have... Then I can't attack. Okay, how do we do this? I want to flip this and attack with it too. No, I guess I can't. Oh wait, that doesn't actually add up. Oh my god, I'm confused. So basically it's just I need to find a spell. I do have lethal next turn anyway. So it should still work. I think it's very unlikely for them to kill me. They can deluge, they have 1 mana left. So I'm at 2, they would need to find... Yeah, they can... Oh, they can have a land. So they can find 2 1 mana... Oh, they can have a shock, actually. But shock sounds like a card that they would board out in this matchup. But yeah, my plan was to find another spell to try to burn this. If I play iteration first, then I can't flip it, so I have to play the 3 mana spell first. Also, them not keeping a mountain on tap maybe tells you that they probably don't have the shock. Or at least not in hand. Well, if they had it in hand, I would have just been dead. Into the Royal. Well, I can kill that. I have 9-10 mana, so I can start with Deluge. So I need to find a spell. Spell is enough to kill them. This flips, that's 8 damage. Hazard is 3, they're at 1. Oh my god, I'm not gonna be able to do it. Are you kidding me? What? What the hell? So I can't attack with any of them because then I die to the land. Oh boy, so I guess I get these two. Oh wait, no, I can counter my own spell. Okay, that works. I can counter my own spell. Oh wait, no, I have two triggers. Okay, what am I doing? I have two triggers. Okay. I thought I was only doing two damage. If I only had one dragon, and I thought I was dealing eight and only had one trigger, whatever. So if I was only doing one trigger, then I could still play this, negate it, and point the two damage at them twice. So that would add up. But yeah, I'm obviously doing more damage than I thought, so it doesn't matter. I think I'm happy with the configuration. It's a pretty slow hand, but I think it's okay. Okay, two lands is definitely not what I was hoping to draw. Okay. I really like the now with the new cards. There's gonna be a lot of playable cards that maybe looked kind of bad, you know, when Throne of Eldraine was the standard. Like, for example, this is a great card. Like, that's a perfectly reasonable, you know, perfectly reasonable standard Magic card. And it's great that now you can just, like, build decks with all these cards and you can, you know, have fun playing Magic in a diverse format again. Well, that's going to be a 4-4. I can't really do anything about it. Yep, I'm taking it. You hate to see it. Oh no, I am dead. I drew four more lands. I am super dead. I'm just literally dead next turn. I needed to draw one of the burn spells or, you know, Heated Debate or Dragon's Fire. Maybe I should have had burn down the house. Yeah, I'm just literally dead. Okay, well that can deal with one. Learn my lesson to play it on their turn. But like any counter spell now for them wins the game because they're going to be able to counter my expensive things for a lot less mana than I'm going to invest in it. Sure. Okay, well, that's something. So I can try to play for the win, or I can like play to not lose. I think I would rather play to try to win. If all I do this turn is play Dragon's Fire to kill one of their creatures, then I'm not using my mana at all to do anything else. I guess I could play Goldspin, hope that they don't have a counter, then Dragon's Fire their thing, and hope that I somehow don't die. He's playing a bit funny. He's not that great either. Play Goldspin attack. If that moves one, play Goldspin attack. Kill the 4/4. Yeah, I think that's the best choice I have. And they have a counter, I die anyway, so it doesn't matter. Okay. All right, GG. Before I leave, make sure you check out channelfireball.com/madness because they're starting the marketplace and there's tons of giveaways. A Black Lotus, a Charizard first edition foil holo something. There's like some Flesh and Blood stuff. A bunch of stuff from across all games. So if you guys want to check it out, all you need to do is just, I think, make any purchase on the marketplace, and that's gonna have you added. That's gonna have you added into the giveaways. I think every $10 spent grants you an entry, so you can have as many as you want per $10. And there's a lot of sweet stuff, a bunch of boxes, foil stuff, promo stuff, store credit, just literally everything. Just make sure you visit the website. It's gonna be a lot of sweet giveaways. I'm gonna play with my cat because he seems to be angry that I kept recording for so long. But thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next time.